guys, what is up? Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is a little different. Today I'm going to organize my bookshelves with you. If you didn't know, slash if you didn't watch my last reading vlog, I did talk about it where we are moving. Well, no, we are not moving, we moved. We literally just moved across the parking lot in the same apartment complex, but we went from a 3-bedroom down to a 2-bedroom. If you weren't aware, my sister and little brother used to live with us, and now it is just us. So we have a 2-bedroom. This second bedroom is my little office slash book room slash beauty room. And this is like my woman cave. And Sam's man cave is kind of just a living room because that's where all of our like gaming systems and everything are. Anyways, so I need to organize my bookshelves. I used to only have one, and now I have two, and I'm really excited about it. Sam's a little self-conscious because he accidentally made this one incorrectly. Just this top piece here is flipped, so don't get mad at me, don't get mad at him. He so graciously put this one together when we first got it and put this one together, you know. Anyways, I'm gonna stop talking because this is a long enough intro. I am going to organize my bookshelves. It is a mad mess down here, a completely mental situation, and I'm trying not to have just total freak out mode about to happen. So, without further ado, let's just put these on the bookshelf. Now, I'm going to probably speed through most of this, maybe like stop speeding a couple of times to give you guys some info or whatevs, but let's do this thing. I just wanna give a shout out to my sis. She read this book last year when it came out in 2018. So she had the Barnes & Noble Black Edition, and your girl did not have that. I had the white one, and I traded a couple books for her, and then we traded our covers because she loves this a lot too. Like, I don't know if she loves this as much as me, like this is one of my favorite books of all time, but she does love this a lot. So it was hard for her to get rid of, but like, how sweet of her. So now I have a matching set, but I am interested in doing a matching set of the non-Barnes & Noble's editions as well, because that's how much I love this book. Anyways, carry on. Of Sam's books that I'm just gonna put like on the top shelf because they're not like cute or mine or aesthetically pleasing. Not that this is particularly aesthetically pleasing, but it's as good as we're gonna get. So what I'm going to do now is just kind of show you everything. I actually need to figure out what to do with this awkward space, but after I do that, I'm going to kind of like do a little tour with you, and then probably in like 6 months when this is completely full, I'm gonna have to do another tour, so let me fix that spot and then I'll do that. Okay, people, we are handheld to get this video going. So I'm gonna go shelf by shelf and just show you what's on it. I'll let you know if, because there are a couple of books, well, probably more than a couple, that I haven't even read yet or a series I haven't finished, and I will let you know when we get to them, and yeah, let's do this. Okay, so on this top shelf, these are all Sam's books. He's read all of them. I don't think either of us have actually read this Just Life book or the Seven Habits of Highly Effective People, because
yeah, I'm not highly effective. On this next shelf, this is kind of like, I didn't know what to do with it. I have the Red Queen series, which I actually loved the first book. Thought the second book was okay, but really slow. The third book I pretty much liked pretty well. Fourth book I did not read because it got spoiled for me and I hated what I heard. So I was like, F that. And obviously I lost two dust jackets and there's a big stain on this, so I don't really care. I have the Torment series by Lauren Kate. Well, I think there was two more books. I remember reading at least three of the four, but I only have two. And this was like back when I was in high school, so yeah. I have this book called My Plain Jane, which is like a retelling of Jane Eyre, and I'm really keen to read it, but we'll see when I get around to it because Jane Eyre is one of my favorite stories of all time. And then Bitter Blue. I'm just gonna like quickly go over things. Bitter Blue by Christian Cashore. Fault in Our Stars. I think I read that when I was like 20, 21 maybe, 20. Strange the Dreamer, which this isn't even the one I want, but it's the one I've got, so yeah. And then I have just some random books right here. Secret of Havisham House, my mother-in-law actually wrote this book, and it is always linked down below in my description box from Amazon. So if you're ever curious, it's a really good book, really cute, good stuff. Yes. On these couple of books are all classics, and then the rest of these are all either duplicates of books I already have in paperback or some other paperback young adult books that I haven't gotten around to, or the Divergent series, because F the Divergent series. So obviously we have like The Outsiders, we have some Shakespeare, we have The Canterbury Tales, which I loved. I read a lot of those in high school senior year. I loved them. Jane Eyre and Wuthering Heights, which are two of my favorites. The Age of Innocence, which I really want to read, but I have not yet. And then I accidentally have two more copies of Wuthering Heights, and then I have a copy of Pride and Prejudice. And these are some duplicates. I have not read Ember in the Ashes. I have not read any of the Infernal Devices, Dark Artifices, or Shadowhunter series. Just not gotten around to it, and there's so many books, so they're quite intimidating, actually. And then, good book, what the F? Like, does anyone else hate that, like, this book with a fiery passion? Because I do. I actually never read it because my sister read it and cried and said, don't even read it. And then she told me everything that happened, and I was like, yeah, I don't need to read it. Next, we have this other shelf, which is books I like a lot. Obviously, I love Throne of Glass. I have read all of them except for Kingdom of Ash. That is my next one on my list here. And then I have A Curse of Dark and Lonely, which I read probably about a month ago now. Incredible book. So amazing. If you've been around my channel for a minute, you know how much I love that. And then I have the Shatter Me series, books 1 through 5. I'm about to finish Ignite Me. I have like 50 pages left, and I'm really liking Ignite Me. The first two were just like good books, but not great. I'm loving Ignite Me, so I'm curious to see what these two are like. And then over here we have my Shadow and Bone series, because if you guys know my thoughts on that, I don't like it. I'm only this far into Ruin and Rising, and I'm trying to convince myself not to DNF it. I have the Smoke and Bone series by Lainey Taylor, which I haven't read yet, but I got them on a really good deal on Amazon. It was like used like new, and I was like, for $17 for all of them hardbacks, I was like, yeah. I have this adorable Winnie the Pooh book. It's really cute. Love Winnie the Pooh. I have two other copies of Graceling, because Graceling is one of my favorite books of all time. This one is a newer print. This is what they print now. I'll show you. It looks like, that was a bad angle. It looks like this. That's what they print now. And I love it because it's green, but the original print is this. And this is, when I originally bought Graceling, I had a hardback, and then I lost it, and then I bought it again in paperback, and then I bought it again in hardback like a couple years ago, but this one is newer, and I wanted it for like a collector's thing, even though I wish it was hardback, but that's okay. We have this George R.R. Martin book, which is, I think, like a 1,000-year prequel to Game of Thrones, but I haven't read it. I got it for Sam. He hasn't read it either. Whoops. We have a Court of Thorns and Roses series, which I want to display in a different place because I love this series, but I'm waiting to get this in hardback. I'm just trying to not buy so many books all at once. And then it'll look a little bit prettier. And I actually have not read A Court of Frost and Starlight. I think I might wait to read A Court of Frost and Starlight until the next book of this series comes out, which I believe is going to be like a Nesta and Cassian like series. So I kind of want to wait till then. And I also have The Gilded Wolves. This shelf right here is kind of also random things. We have this book, which is by Wesley King, created by Kobe Bryant. If you don't know anything about me, basketball is one of the most important things in my entire life. Kobe Bryant, he's my motivation for everything. He's an Oscar winner, a MVP, a five-time NBA championship. He can speak five languages. Like, he's just crushing it in business and sports and everything. I want to be just like him. I'm really keen to read this before the end of summer. I'm just like craving to read it, but I have so much to read, so I'm putting that off for now. But anyways, then I have another copy of Fire by Kristen Kishore, which you will see later on. This is my favorite book of all time. I have this Marvel book, which is called Destiny Arrives, which is actually like the second half of the Infinity War movie. I need to get the first book, which is called like The Pirate Angel. Anyways, it's like about Thor's. Anyways, it's the first half of Infinity War. I have my Iron Man Funko Pop. I have this copy of Jane Eyre and this copy of Wuthering Heights. These are like the Barnes & Noble's copies. Love them. I have Graceling, which you saw on the shelf up here. This is my hard copy version. I have a Funko Pop of Goose from Captain Marvel. I have my Hunger Games trilogy, which is one of my favorite book series of all time. I have this series called Storm Siren, which I actually really enjoyed the first two books. I haven't read the third one because when the third one came out, I was in my like three-year reading slump, so I haven't read it and I need to get around to it. And then Crimson Bound, which I never finished, but the other book that Rosamund Hodge wrote is one of my favorite books. I'll show you that later. Coming over here, this is one of my favorite, like, aesthetically pleasing shelves. We have the Hush Hush series, which I love. I mean, I know it's a little cheesy, but, like, I read those in high school, and they were the ish. Like, they were everything to me. I have this Nightmare Before Christmas snow globe, which one of my good friends gave to me. This is my favorite, one of my favorite movies of all time, so, obviously. That's an Owl Crate bookmark. It's a wooden bookmark. It's like a Game of Thrones quote. And then I have a Funko Pop of Sally. I have Nevernight, which I'm going to read this month. I have all these other books. I'm not going to say all the names because I'm going to freaking lose my voice. Here's Cruel Beauty, which I was saying is the other one to Crimson Bound. Love that book. I have Fire by Kristen Kishore, my favorite book of all time. And then I have Six of Crows duology and then The King of Scars. Haven't read these three yet. That will probably be... well, this one hopefully this month, and then these two hopefully May or June. Down here, we have the classic Twilight. I have Loki and Thor Funko Pop, and then I have The Host by Stephenie Meyer, which is 100 times better than Twilight, but I love it. It's one of my favorite books. Have some other books. Most of them I haven't read, to be honest with you. Caraval through Onyx and Ivory, all those books in between, I have not read them yet. I'm hoping to read Caraval this month. And then I have The Cruel Prince and The Wicked King by Holly Black. On display, The Cruel Prince, because it's one of my favorite books of all time. Over here, we have my Harry Potter shelf, which needs some TLC. And I'm hoping to give it some TLC soon. We have, obviously, 1 through 7 Harry Potter. I don't have dust jackets for the last two, so I will be picking up brand new copies of those in the future. But if you know anything about Harry Potter, they're like 27 books. They're like 27 bucks. So they're quite expensive, so it's really not something I want to buy all at once. And then I have the two 20th anniversary editions, one of Philosopher's Stone, the other one of Chamber of Secrets, and then in June this year, The Prisoner of Azkaban comes out in the Slytherin edition. So these came out the 20th anniversary of each book, and they came out in house colors, so I'm a Slytherin, I bought mine and Slytherin. My husband is a Ravenclaw. He has both of them in the Ravenclaw edition. They're really awesome. And then I have the original screenplay of The Crimes of Grindelwald. I need to buy the original Fantastic Beasts, but it is also $25, so I'm waiting on that one. But I'm really keen to read these ones soon as well because I love the Fantastic Beasts series. I love the second one better than the first, actually, but I love them in general. This is Dumbledore from the Fantastic Beasts series. He's one of my favorite characters of all time ever, but I especially adore him in the Fantastic Beasts series in The Crimes of Grindelwald. Like, I love him so much. So I have this awesome Funko Pop of him. And he looks amazing. And I also love Jude Law, so it just helps. This bottom shelf is kind of like a hot mess. It's my Marvel books. I have one comic. It's a Loki comic where he does like agent stuff for like Asgardians. And then I have this book, which is an official movie special. It's kind of cool. It has a lot of information on like costumes and sets. And then I have the first 10-year book. And then I have this huge visual dictionary of Marvel Studios stuff. This is all like MCU stuff though, not like Marvel Studios. It's really cool though. And then our last shelf here, if this video already is not long enough, I have Moonflower by J.D. Slacker. If you guys have watched my videos for a while now, you know this is one of my favorite books of all time. I'm actually friends with the author, and he went through something really, really impactful and sad in his life, and he chose to create a story about it and write about it to help himself grieve and move on and to help remember the memory, like to keep the memory alive of what happened, like the person that the thing happened to. Anyways, it's the most, one of the most beautiful stories I've ever read in my entire life. I highly recommend. It's $14 on Amazon. It is always linked down below, so please check it out. I have The Great Gatsby, which I want to get like a really sick copy of since it's one of my favorite books of all time. I have the Guernsey Literary, that book, love that book. I don't even want to say the full name, it's so long. A Monster Calls, which is one of my favorite books of all time. And then we have The Hobbit, Lord of the Rings series, which I will be reading this year as well. And then we have the Mara Dyer series, which I have read the first two books. I did not read the third one, and I haven't read the one that's in Noah's perspective.
So guys, I'm going to wrap up this video. It is so long already, so I'm not really going to get into much else in this outro. I did want to say, obviously this is a work in progress. Obviously I have quite a few empty spaces going on here, but if you know anything about me, you know that I have a hard time saying no to buying a book, so this might fill up fast. Also, I know that like some of my Funko Pop are crammed, but I want them in areas where they can be seen by the camera, because when I do sit down and film, you're not going to be able to see the entire bookshelf, and yeah, this is a work in progress. Things will change and move, but I'm going to try and like put those in reading vlogs when I do change and move these things, and then probably in about 6 months or so, I'll do an updated bookcase tour, and we can all do that together. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. I love you so very much. I hope you have a great morning, noon, evening, day, night, whatever happens to be that you're watching this video, and I will see you in my next one. Bye!